Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm Carrie.
I'm Janine.
And we are here at the Passionate Home in Langley for our Friday Idea Ladies session.
Yeah.
Or, yeah.
Every week.
Every week, except for last week. So sorry about last week. Had a little injury, couldn't make it in. But we're here now, and it's not just the two of us.
Yeah.
We've got the whole team here this morning. So, good morning. If you are there, please say good morning. Krista's behind the camera, and if you have any questions, just type it on in, and she will let us know that you're there and what your questions are. And if you're watching this later, again, put it in the comments, because today's show is going to be amazing. So I thought what we'd do this morning is start a little differently, and let's introduce you to the team. So, who wants to start?
I'm Candace, and I'm a hoarder.
I'm Lori. I'm a hoarder.
I'm Carrie. I'm a hoarder.
I'm Janine. I might be a hoarder.
Hoarder. I'm Teresa. I'm a hoarder too.
Natalie, definite hoarder.
Perfect.
So, yeah, Krista.
I'm not a hoarder, so.
Oh, come on.
So today we are going to talk about, are we hoarders or are we collectors?
Right.
Maybe some of you are wondering the same thing about yourself or somebody that you live with. So I feel like we're kind of have a group confessional here,
right?
And we're going to talk about the difference of hoarding and collecting, what we each collect, and why. Does this sound fun?
Perfect.
Is there anybody there this morning, Krista?
We've got lots of people on saying hello. Yep.
Okay. So I'm going to start. I'm going to be quiet because my husband's upstairs and he might not agree with me, but I collect old gold frames. Mm-hmm. What I love most about them is all the beautiful detail, and even when they're chipped like this, it has history. It's telling a story on its own, and I hang them just empty. I think they're art on their own. I collect them in all different shapes and sizes, and if you are a hoarder slash collector, when you see something that you love, it's just like, I have to have it. Have to have it. I have no wall space whatsoever to hang anything
right?
else.
Yeah.
So now I just have them stacked on the floor, like biggest to smallest, so it still looks attractive.
Mike has two things to say. Number one, he can hear you. And number two, what about your pillow collection?
That's another day. But yeah, I hang them just as art. And then some people come to the house and go, you have an empty frame. I'm like, it's open to interpretation.
Exactly.
You could hang something inside, like another frame. You could hang an animal head. You could put in a Sid Dickens.
Yeah,
you could even just clip something. So really, they're super useful. And I'm always moving things around. I don't know about you girls. Always redecorating. And so I'm so thankful that I have all these choices that I don't have to keep going out to the store and buying more because I have my own stash. So that is my little sweet spot are these beautiful gold frames.
That would look so good lying down too, like almost like a tray, like putting a candle arrangement in the center of that.
Absolutely.
So like have it lying down and have candles or something in it.
That's actually a great idea. You could put a mirror underneath this if you were setting a table.
Oh, you need it. Right? You could probably fit a few more frames now.
There you go.
Seriously, because now you can lie them down.
Right?
Yeah. Small, big. Well, there are so many things you could do with frames. So
for sure.
Very useful collection.
Yes.
Tori says that you could put like a vinyl like saying or word in each frame.
Yeah.
You could totally.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We did that at the store before. We've done something different now, but it said beautiful, right?
Well, so in all the different frames.
Yeah.
I mean, you could collect a whole gallery wall of different frames.
Totally.
And then, yeah.
Perfect.
So that is my confession, people.
Can I confess next? Okay. So I think I'm probably a hoarder, actually. I collect anything pretty that I might need in the future. I'm doing a reno, and I just feel like I need it all. But I'll focus on iron orchid design transfers right now because they're so pretty. I love the tubes, you guys. Like, look at this basket in my art room. It just helps me feel legit. Like, I don't even want to open these or use them, but the tubes are just, like, so pretty. I can't even if it's empty, I'm going to keep that and just, I just love them, you guys.
Well, like, I love how you've collected all these things that are of similar color. Like, right? She's got twine in here, you know, and the strapping for upholstery.
Yeah.
I mean, even that is beautiful. Mm-hmm. Beautiful.
It's just my little collection. I mean, I have more of these.
Can we talk about how many of those are open, Janine?
Well, I've opened two. There's still lots of pieces in here. I know. I don't know what it is. I don't want to use them because they're so pretty that I'm scared that I'm never going to be able to get this again. What is wrong with me?
It's funny because when we decided to do this video, I thought for sure you would confess to the amount of china you have.
Yeah, there's a few collections, you guys, but this is the one I brought today. I told my husband also, please don't watch this morning's video, and he's like, oh, it's on.
It's funny how it overlaps too, because I'm sitting over here drooling at some of
it. Right.
I can give you all my empty tubes.
Well, talking about drooling, let's go with Lori next, because what Lori has here, we're all drooling over. I don't know about you, but check this out.
So I love collecting vintage bottles wherever I go. Like, some people bring back things that say, oh, I went to, I don't know, Hawaii. I'm like, ooh, can I find an old bottle? I love how useful they are. I just stack them up on my windowsills, loving the light, how it comes through. This is my little turquoise collection. And what I love about them is whenever you're having a party or I decorate for weddings, you can just take little clippings out of your garden, or my daughter and I actually walk the trails by our house and pull weeds like buttercups out. Mm. And it's so inexpensive to always have beautiful fresh florals in your house.
Such a good idea.
Amazing.
Yeah. Right? Mm-hmm. So think, like, buying a bouquet, that's going to be like $60, but you've got all these little bottles and, absolutely, you know, like, even just got little feathers in there. I love bringing the outdoors in. Right, putting them with some little stones.
This is incredible. So I have a small collection of bottles as well. And at Christmas time one year, I set them all up on the mantle and just put a small holiday ball in each one. Just the simplicity of it was beautiful. Yeah. So multi-purpose, Lori.
And just consider where you're getting your little bottles. Like, this is even a little tiny salt shaker. Just take the top off.
Oh,
great.
So smart.
Right?
Love it.
Look how pretty that is.
I actually think...
Do you guys love that idea?
Yeah.
I've got apple blossoms at home. I know what I'm going to do with them.
Sylvia said she cherishes her little bottle collection too.
Yeah, consider too, right? Like, in this day and age right now where it's just... Everybody's a bit sad.
Yeah.
Could you imagine just dropping a little posy like that off on somebody's desk or at a doorstep?
Mm-hmm. Any day, Lori. Any day.
I'm not going to lie. I came to work a couple of times, and Lori has left me a little cutting and a little thing on my desk, and it just brought me very much joy. And they're empty now, just so you know.
Okay. I'll change some stuff up.
No pressure. Awesome. Teresa, what did you bring us today?
I brought what I call a collection. Others in my house might disagree. I collect antique bent covers, and I find them, they're all different. So every one of them I see, I fall in love with it. And they have so many uses. I put them on my mantle, or I have a little bit ugly water shut off in my downstairs bathroom. So this one just sits right against the wall and covers it up, and it looks really pretty.
That's gorgeous.
Yeah, or anything that looks like one, like I have some old mail slots that go in the door.
Oh,
yes. It might be a mailman, so that's the attraction there, I think.
Aww.
And then this one is one of my favorites, and I think a couple people here too. Just the old rusty.
That's beautiful.
They just sit up on the mantle.
Can I just make it extra special here?
Absolutely. That is perfect.
So pretty.
Perfect.
Oh my goodness, that's wicked. Yeah.
We are making art, people.
Yeah.
We're gonna have to pack. Even that one would fit in there.
Yeah. You're
gonna have to pack Carrie down later.
We're
getting
that. Yeah.
And then if my dog scratches a piece of furniture or something, just pop one of these in front of it. So I get around to painting it, hides it, and I love it. It's perfect.
Honestly, Teresa, I love it. I feel like now I want to collect.
Yeah,
I know.
No kidding.
We'll be fighting over the collection.
They're not all over. They're not everywhere, so they're kind of hard to find sometimes. Mm-hmm. So when you find one, it's that much more exciting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know? And
I
if it's one that doesn't look like one that I already have, it's that much better.
Oh.
And then I have to go home and find somewhere to hide it in with everything else.
Do you find them at flea markets, or where do you find your collection most often?
Honestly, right now, well, we don't have flea markets, we don't have garage sales, but that's where a lot of them, online sometimes you can find them. Or just walking down the street, people just...
Well, yeah, because some people, this is junk, right?
Like, who wants, you know?
The patina and the rust and
the chicken stunning. Is this kind of... stay open. You could put art in here.
Yeah. Yeah.
I love that.
I feel like some of the like Surrey New and Used and stuff would have something
like
this.
Yeah, for sure.
Maybe this could be right. We just have little,
like, we're just putting the collections together. All of our
collections. Do you see how well they intermingle?
I feel like we're all a little bit enablers here.
We are.
Kat says that we could, you could use those for pot trivets.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah,
that's a great idea.
Yeah.
So pretty.
I'm not going to lie, Teresa, I also have a few of them, and I just love, I don't know, something about it, the metal, the beauty, the detail. Wow, thanks for confessing here today.
I'm going to have to come to your house and check it.
Natalie?
Okay, well, I wasn't allowed to bring in my pet collection. Janine said no. So I opted for books. So... my grandmother used to translate books from German to English for universities and stuff. And there's just something, she always had these old books. So when she passed, I took all her old books. So I have a thing about books. So these are just old books that I love. And I love the paper inside them. They're just different than the paper now. And they have a smell. And somebody told me, don't smell the books. That's like a mold or something. I'm like, mold has never smelled so good to me. And it's funny because everything is online now. So I do, because I'm such a voracious reader, I do read on my iPad, but then I'm horrible because then if I love the book, I have to have the paper copy. Like, I have to have it. Yeah. And then I go and I get them signed by the author. So I'm a huge, like, I love antique books and I love romance novels. But for decorating, I mean, I have, I think, 3 bookshelves in our house, and so I have them by collection. So I have all the antique Shakespeare's together, have all these ones together, and then I have vintage novels gorgeous. From about 100 years ago, all color coordinated, and with little twinkle lights in them. And then I have my romance section that's in my office. But you know, they're so great for props. Like, we've shown in here, you've shown how you do your books with the ribbon and the painting and stuff. But even we just had Easter, and I had some cookbooks, vintage cookbooks done, and I put some florals and Easter eggs and Christmas.
Yeah.
I use them to decorate. I have a plant on one with our little prayer beads with the heart going across.
Can I see the spine of that one?
Yeah.
I just want to see.
Coaching Joyfully says she's a book hoarder too and can't get rid of one single book.
No, you can't. You feel guilty. Like, I feel like it's somebody's sweat and blood they've put into this story. And I love that when you have old books, also, you know, if all the, if you have them all on a device, if it goes down, you don't have it. I feel like this is, the printed book is losing its place. So I just love having them.
Yeah. Anybody else collect old books? I know Lori. Anybody out there? That's awesome. Thanks for sharing. Candace?
Okay, so.
We're having camera troubles. Hold on one second. There we go. There!
I was going to start by saying that I collect Sid Dickens titles, and I do, and I love them. And I was telling my family, oh, I'm going to talk about this. What do we collect? And my daughter looks at me like I'm a nut bar, and she's like, Mom, you hoard furniture. And so, true story, I hoard furniture. I find it all over the place. I look at the bones and I think it's so beautiful, and I can't get rid of it. So I know it can be beautiful. So, but here's a little confession. So this week I was home and I painted my front door. And it's not everyone's cup of tea. It's really rusty and rustic. And I love it. And somebody said, is that your front door? And I'm like, yes, it is. And they said, well, does it suit the surrounding? So I took a step back and took this photo.
Now we see me. Hi, guys.
Oh, yeah. Oh, sorry.
And I was like, why do I see myself?
So, funny thing, Gail, if you're watching, she's like, oh, Candace, I love that entrance.
And then I thought I'd out myself and be real. So if you did a 160.
This is a safe zone.
This is for real. So if you did a 160 with that camera, this is what the rest of that undercover area looks like. So there's a sofa. There's this beautiful piece that's painted ready to come in. There's a table, and I think there's 20 chairs. There's a desk. Oh. So, yeah, I'm Hoarder.
Oh, my
goodness. You know what? It's going to be beautiful. And this little, I don't know if you can see down here, Krista. These were just ugly, burgundy, boring, and I've made them beautiful with some Andy Sloan chalk paint and with some Andy transfers. So, you know.
Pretty. Yeah.
So save those beautiful pieces. Or what? Call me. No, don't. Actually, funny thing. So Carrie yesterday sent me something on Marketplace. She's like, hey, Candace. And I sent her a message, and I sent this photo, and I said, please, you're feeding my addiction.
I won't tell you what I said when I saw that photo.
Yeah, I told Larry.
My husband says, whatever you do, don't take a picture of our garage. So if you are out there and your garage is filled with furniture, or your cupboards are filled with books or bottles or useless, just kidding. Or just beautiful things, you are not alone.
Yeah.
This is a safe zone. We would love for you to share what you hoard slash collect.
Maggie says she loves painted doors. She collects painted doors. Yeah.
They're so pretty. Mm-hmm.
Like painted doors? I wonder what she does with them all.
Stack them like behind the couch or in an undercovered area.
Sometimes people use them as decor,
separators.
Right?
Yeah. So pretty.
Wow.
Beautiful in the garden.
So please share with us in the comments below what you love to collect. We would love to
start collecting it,
right?
We would love to start collecting.
See the value in that. Or the door.
Denise says her hubby is watching on the side. He collects every Louis L'Amour.
Oh, we had a Louis L'Amour collection at our house. We do.
He's an artist.
He's an author. Yeah. My husband collects him too. So yeah. Oh,
yeah, it's
I think
bad.
I've read most of them. Yeah.
My son has inherited my collection, and he has two monster bookcases in his bedroom too, and he won't get rid of them, and now my daughter, and so now I'm on Marketplace looking for bookcases to line, you know, under windows and stuff, because we have a problem. We need an intervention.
Okay. Yeah. You know you have a problem when you just can't let it go, but what is it? What is it in our minds that we just have to have it?
I don't know.
Well, we are so blessed that we are able to have all these wonderful things.
That's
right?
True. That's
so true. We want to thank you for joining us. I felt like I said to the girls, we're going to be like The View.
Round table.
All together, making our confessions. This is a safe zone. So next week.
Yeah.
What are we going to do?
Well, we're coming up with a flower pot challenge, you guys, with some Annie Sloan chalk paint. So we're going to paint some flower pots next week and give you some ideas and let you know all the details about that challenge coming up.
I think that'll be fun. We're going to challenge you to get outside, get creative, and get painting.
Yeah.
So that will be next Friday at
9:30.
So thank you so much. Please leave in the comments what you love to collect. We would love to see what those are. Right. And
just before we go, I'm going to say, Twisted Sisters Upcycle says, oh my God, my garage, it's insane with furniture and vintage goodness. But she also has a storage locker.
I need one.
Well, another meeting.
We could get a group storage locker,
right?
We have some vintage teacup collections.
Oh yeah, yes. I used to do that too.
Me too.
Yeah.
And her husband has 100+ boxes of Lego.
Oh,
wow.
Yeah,
my brother.
Yeah.
Nice. It is okay. Just one last thing. This is my advice. Remember that one day we can't take it all with us. So don't leave it for somebody else to clean up. Start gifting the things that you love so that you don't become a hoarder. Enjoy it while you can, but know when to let go.
Perfect.
So stay safe. Thank you so much for watching this week, and we will see you next Friday. Bye.
Bye.
Oops, sorry. It's not shutting off.